السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1366 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala, we present to you a lesson on Masjidul Aqsa. Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam's beautiful hadith mentioned in Bukhari Sharif, and it is Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala reporting from the master Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam, la tusafirul mar'a yawmayn illa ma'a zawjiha aw dhu mahramin, that a lady, remember, can only travel with her husband or with a mahram. So meaning that she cannot go with anybody, a stranger, or travel alone. So all that will be haram when it is 48 miles or more, 78 kilometers or more. Wala sawma fi yawmain, and you cannot fast on these 2 days, al-fitr wal-adha, Eidul Fitr, 1st of Shawwal, and Eidul Adha, the 10th of Zilhijjah. Likewise, the 11th, 12th, 13th of Zilhijjah, Ayyamut Tashriq, also is haram to fast. Wala salata ba'da salatain, you can't read nafil salat and so forth after 2 first salats, ba'da subhi hatta tatlu ash-shams, after fajr salat till the sun rises, wa ba'da al-asri hatta taghrub, after asr salat till sunset, you can't read nafil salat. So this is mentioned all in Bukhari Sharif. Then Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, wala tushaddu rihal, you can't undertake a special journey, illa ila thalathati masajid, but to 3 masjid. You want to go to a masjid for a program, lecture, all that is fine. But to go to a particular masjid and say, if I read there, I will get more reward, that's wrong. So yes, the extra reward is in Makkah Mukarramah, Masjidul Haram, 100,000, Madinah Munawwara, 50,000, the weak hadith, 1,000, the sahih hadith, but it's greater reward, and Masjidul Aqsa, 1,000 reward or 500 reward. So according to the various ahadith in Mishkat Sharif, Musnad Ahmad, so these 3 masajid, you get special reward, and Masjid Quba also, you get special reward of Umrah. So as mentioned in Mishkat Sharif, Musnad Ahmad and Ibn Majah, so one is Haram Sharif, one is Masjidul Aqsa, and Masjidi, my Masjid, Masjidun Nabawi. So that is what we believe in. Now the Ummah needs to go to Masjidul Aqsa. Why? Because Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, man ahalla bihajjatin aw umratin min al-Masjidul Aqsa, whosoever makes Umrah from Masjidul Aqsa, the hadith is reported on the authority of Umm Salama, 3 things will happen to her, to that person there, to that male or female who fastens ihram nowadays for Umrah from there. Then ghafarallahu lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi wa ma ta'akhkhar, the previous sins will be forgiven, the future sins will be forgiven, wa wajabat lahu al-jannah, and jannat will be, inshallah, he'll be entitled to go to jannah. So subhanallah, these are the great virtues which Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned, the hadith in Abu Dawood. Similarly, Hazrat Maymuna radiallahu anha asked, aftina fi baytil maqdis ya Rasulullah, O Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you give us the fatwa regarding baytul muqaddas and baytul maqdis. So Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, hiya ardul mahshar wal manshar, you will be resurrected there, the hadith in Ibn Majah, Musnad Ahmad. So look at this hadith mentioned in Sunan Nasai. Nabi Sulaiman alayhi salatu salam reconstructed Masjidul Aqsa. After that, he recited 3 du'as. First du'a, he said, Rabbi habli mulkan la yanbaghi li ahadin min ba'di. Ya Allah, you are the best of givers, so give me a vast, big kingdom. Nobody else must have such a kingdom. Lo and behold, Almighty Allah blessed him with such a kingdom. Second one, he made dua to Almighty Allah, uwati'u hukmi hukmak, when I pass a verdict, it must concur with your judgment and your verdict of Almighty Allah. And fa'a'tahu iyyah, Almighty Allah gave it to him. And then the third one, he said, Man ata hadhal bayt, who comes to Majidul Aqsa, la yuridu illa salata fi, with no ulterior motive but to read salat here, kharaja min zunubihi kayomin waladatu ummuhu, he comes out so pure and purified and cleansed from his sins like the day his biological mother gave birth to him. May Almighty Allah liberate Majidul Aqsa from the enemies and liberate the whole of Palestine. Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.